Hi everyone, my name is Tyler Stanczak, and in this video in particular, I'm going to be showing you how to add video to your PowerPoint presentations. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, so as you can see here, I have two slides, and on the first slide is the video, and I'm going to show you guys how you can actually import video into your presentation, and then also how you can have it play in the background while your text is showing up or other animations to really liven up the presentation. Alright, so for starters, I have this slide, and in order to actually click on this, because right now I can't do anything with it, I just go to View Slide Master, and this is where my video is sitting. So if you are looking for places on where you can get high quality video, you can check out pexels.com, or you can also check out pixabay.com. And both of those sites have really good resources on high quality video that you can use for free in your presentation. Also, make sure to watch out for a couple of disclaimers on those sites just in case you need to credit the offer. But for this demonstration, it's just for educational purposes. So I'm just going to show you guys how to add video to a presentation. I actually ended up getting this video from pexels.com. I can't remember the exact name of it, but it might have been like particles or abstract or technology, something around there. And what this video looks like if I play it, this is what it looks like in slow motion. So it does go on for a while, so you do have the option to edit it. If you want to trim, you can do so here and make it a little shorter if you're not wanting it as long. You can also, if you right click and do style, you can choose what kind of framing, if you want like soft edges or curves like that. You can also have it do a click in sequence, so the video wouldn't start until you actually click your mouse, or you can do it automatically. I recommend choosing the automatic option just because right when you get to that slide, you probably want that background video to play, but just in case you don't, that is an option for you. Now, you may be wondering, how do I actually get this video into the presentation? So here's where I'm going to show you how you can get this video here. So if I close out of this and then go to insert, there's a section over here underneath media where it's called video. You can go here in the drop down and you can either do online video, which there are some options there to find video, or you can do a video from your PC if you ended up downloading a certain type of footage. So I'm going to choose this option. And then I see this lines video animation right here. So I'm going to click on this and do insert. All right. So now I have my video footage here. What you can do is you can line it up to the left right there and make sure it's all the way in the corner, and then hold down shift and drag it all the way to the right. So that fills up the whole entire presentation. And now when I play this, it's going to play the same exact video that I had in this background. And another thing to note is that when you are adding video to a presentation, I recommend putting it in the slide master just because as you're adding more things to that slide, you're not going to have to worry about moving around that video or altering the video in any way. Like let's say I'm inserting a shape and then I'm trying to click on the shape, but I accidentally click on this and then it's shifting around. So what's nice with the slide master is anything in the slide master you can't click on, but you can click on this shape. So that's why I recommend putting in the slide master. So let's say you do put in the slide master. A couple of features I recommend when putting video in slide master. One, make sure it's lined up with the slide so it's covering everything, all the white. And you can make sure if it, for some reason, the video is a different sizing and it's not 16:9, you can always crop it. So in this case, I enlarged my video a little bit and cropped it down to fit the slide. And then you can just click off the screen anywhere to close out the cropping. So once it's fit there, click on the video, and then this playback option is going to open up. And underneath video options, you have all these different features you can pick from for your video. So for starting, like I said earlier, I would do automatically. You can do click and sequence. So then when you click, then it'll start playing. But I always like to have it automatically. I also like to have it loop until it stops. So let's say you're presenting the slide and then it's going longer than the actual video of what you're presenting. The video will just replay itself, so it'll never stop until you go to the next slide. There's a couple of other boxes here that you can check as well, but I usually just leave my settings like this. And then another thing to note is when you click on this video, go to animations and then animation pane. And you're going to want to make sure that both of these are set to play. And then you're going to also want to make sure that they're start with previous. So that way you don't have to click anything. When you get to that slide, it just plays automatically. This one right here, this line, sometimes it shows paused, but I would just always make sure it has play on there so you're good to go. All right, so now you can exit out of the animation pane and you can also exit out of slide master. And now when I go into presentation mode, it just plays your video automatically. And then you can put stuff on that slide as well. So in the next slide, I show a demonstration of what text would look like on top of video. And let's say this is like a title slide. So, and this is just an example, but you have artificial intelligence, the power of data, and then I can put in presentation mode. And look how nice that looks. It just gives the whole title page a whole new level of professionalism, and it looks very nice, super rich, super clean. It's very engaging with the users. And I guarantee you a lot of other presentation makers and designers are not doing this. They should be, but they're not. And I really think this gives you a level up with your presentation, especially for a title slide, because it's nice to have a little bit of a subtle video in the background to make something look really nice and pop. All right, so that is how you can add video to any presentation in PowerPoint. If you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, make sure to check out my course on Udemy in the description below. I have a discount code for you guys for making it this far in the video. And lastly, let me know what you guys are looking for next. So without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Thanks.